name's Jim Rumbaugh, and I was a harmonica owner for many years before I became a harmonica player. I think I picked a harmonica up somewhere back about 98 or so on a trip back home. One of these $5 harmonicas I picked up at the Cracker Barrel, where I bought, paid $5 for a harmonica, but then I spent $15 for the book on how to play the harmonica. And that got me started, but I actually became more of a harmonica owner than a harmonica player. Well, in 2001, I ran across someone that said, hey, there's going to be a harmonica club starting here in just a few days. I said, well, that sounds like fun. I might try it out. And the next day, it was Sunday, and I looked in the newspaper, and there was, says, yeah, harmonica club going to start up. I said, thank goodness that article came up, and somebody told me twice, because you kind of have to hit me upside the head twice for me to remember it. So on a Tuesday night, we went to a little barbecue place that on 9th Street in downtown Huntington. And there was a gentleman by the name of Eddie Blue Dawson and Brian Salters. And they were putting together this club and this event that was just centered for harmonica players only. And thank goodness they started, because once I started hanging with these guys, they actually showed me how to play the harmonica. And it's going from there. So since 2001, I've been spending all my time just learning how to play the harmonica. You see, there's an old saying that says it takes 5 minutes to learn, but 5 years to master. Well, I kind of got unhappy at the end of 5 years because I hadn't mastered it yet. So I'm here at about my 11-year mark, and I'm pretty much happy with how I play it, and I'm having a lot of fun. And as I learn, I try to share my learning with all the other people that come here to the Harmonica Club every Tuesday night from 7 to 9 here at Gino's Pub. Just walk in. Doesn't matter how good or how bad you are. Come on in. We'll find a seat for you, and you can join in on the fun and learn something, because that's what it's all about. People learning and helping each other and having fun.
Hold that train. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
Darryl Brown. And I started playing harmonica when I was 14 years old. That's 64 years ago. And I've probably played it more in the last 10 years than I have altogether. Love to play it. I've been accused of playing almost any street corner, and it happens. But I love music. I love the harmonica.
Stewart, aka Harmonica Lady. I started playing about 7 years ago. I am a product, as well as Jane. We actually were at the same Hilltop Festival gig where we do the free 5-minute harmonica lesson. And I really enjoyed playing that afternoon and decided I take the guides up seriously and started showing up on Tuesday nights. Thoroughly enjoyed it. And I've just been hanging out with him ever since.
Well, I ain't gonna work on the railroad. Ain't gonna work on the farm. Lay around the shack till the bell train comes back. And roll in my sweet baby's arms. Roll in my sweet baby's arms. Roll in my sweet baby's arms. Comes back and rolling in my sweet.
name is Karen, and played music my whole life, but never really out, and decided I just wanted to play out. So I went to the bakery, River and Rail Bakery, and I met Paula. I think he just interviewed Paula. And we hung out for a couple of Saturdays and sang together and did some songs. And then she said, why don't you come to Gino's? So I've been coming to Gino's every Tuesday that I possibly can for about a year and a half.
Your family, friends, and neighbors are featured on Armstrong Local Programming. Meet fascinating people. Visit new places. Enjoy special events. Armstrong has our community like no one else. Hometown favorites are available on demand with your television plus subscription. Or find a complete program schedule at armstrongonewire.com. Local programming exclusively from Armstrong. One wire, infinite possibilities.
Okay, so back in 2001, Fred Miller was a member of the Harmonica Club and was one that taught me most of these straight harps tunes or traditional tunes that we do. And this was his favorite song in the key of C. It's called Happy Wanderer. And yes, you all get to sing along with us. Daryl, I expect to see you, and Bob, I expect to see you up here before the song is over, okay? And it's not too long of a walk, is it? Happy Wanderer. One, two, three.
Well, it started when I was at the senior center, and it was on a Saturday, and I was in there playing alone. Finally, everyone started following. The drummer came in, and then there was a banjo player that had come in, and that's how I really got started with them, was their senior centers. They all started following me, and they asked me if I wanted to be with them, and I said, yes, I'd love to.
A knack for it. I just learned how to do it pretty easily. I enjoyed the informality of just the jam session of the club each Tuesday night, and making new friends while I was here. They played all different kinds of music, and I like all different kinds of music, so that's what kept me here.
When I get low, get on my telephone. Now when I get low, don't care if I die.
Okay, I'm Tom Dobbins. I play the bass. I've been with them since 05. Really kind of stumbled into it because I was in the bell choir at our church. And they originally started out, I believe, at the Java joint, which was right across from the church. And I saw these guitar players and drummers start going into this little room. And I said, well, I wonder what's going on. So I stopped in there, and sure enough, they had guitar players and harmonica players, and I started strumming with them. And then it kind of took off from there. And so I've been with them since that time.
Your family, friends, and neighbors are featured on Armstrong Local Programming. Meet fascinating people, visit new places, enjoy special events. Armstrong has our community like no one else. Hometown favorites are available on demand with your television plus subscription. Or find a complete program schedule at armstrongonewire.com. Local programming, exclusively from Armstrong. One wire, infinite possibilities.
Silver wave.
I'm retired, and I used to play way back in the 50s and 60s, and then when I got married, I kind of gave it all up. So I retired about 9 years ago, and then I kind of stumbled back into it. So I'm kind of back in my teeny bopper days.
It's the interaction that we have with each other, and when someone else hears a part in your song, it's just the kind of magic that you get when two musicians, three musicians, however many we have for the night, when they can all come together and play a song. It's kind of magical.
Thank you.
Well, I started out, I was walking to school for about probably a half a mile, and I was, no doubt, I was lonesome, so I started playing harmonica just to kind of have some company, more or less. And I bought a little old harmonica. It was a red and white plastic harmonica in a 10-cent store. And that was back when the 10-cent stores were great. And a little sheet of paper came with it. Had old Susanna, old Black Joe, and Swanee River. And I wore that son of a gun out. Enjoyment. I see people's faces. Looks like they're enjoying it too, and that makes you feel even better.
Your family, friends, and neighbors are featured on Armstrong Local Programming. Meet fascinating people, visit new places, enjoy special events. Armstrong has our community like no one else. Hometown favorites are available on demand with your television plus subscription. Or find a complete program schedule at armstrongonewire.com. Local programming exclusively from Armstrong. One wire, infinite possibilities.
It's a lot of fun. I mean, that's all it is. It's all about, you know, being great fun.
Somebody else.
Harmonica, number one, is it's so incredibly portable. As someone says, you're a pocket musician. You can always have your instrument with you. Now, since I was a young man, I've played bass guitar. I'd play that bass guitar 20, 30 years, but you don't just pull out a bass guitar and start playing a tune. When I had the harmonica, if I'm sitting there at the gas station pumping gas, you know, what better way to spend a little time, pull out that harmonica, play a tune, because you're not going to be doing anything else except staring off into space. And all those times when you're sitting in a parking lot waiting for someone to come out of a store, pull out that harmonica and do a tune. So you're, what used to be wasted time is now fun time. It's practical time. It's time spent to good use as I practice my craft and learn new skills and learn new tunes. So there's always something for me to do. I don't have any boring moments, thanks to the harmonica.
just love the bunch of them because we all seem to get along and everything seems to go pretty smooth. And we help one another. And I really like it.
Come at every meeting. I live about 40 miles away, so it's a little tough to get here. I also have a commitment every Tuesday night for praise team in our church. So it's a matter of skipping one or the other. I sort of have to choose my church.
If they play something, we'll let anybody play anything. It's just an open jam session. And we do focus on harmonicas pretty heavy because we are the Harmonica Club. But we like to have a guest guitarist every now and then, or perhaps a banjo player. We've had mandolin players. It's just a lot of fun. And we're a very warm, open group, so we'll let pretty much anybody hang with us.
Thank you.
who you can, help out where you can, get a harmony part, get a rhythm, just make some music and have a good time. My band.